Neural Lander uses AI to land drones smoothly. Landing multi-rotor drones smoothly is difficult. Complex turbulence is created by the airflow from each rotor bouncing off the ground as the ground grows ever closer during a descent. This turbulence is not well understood, nor is it easy to compensate for, particularly for autonomous drones. That is why takeoff and landing are often the two trickiest parts of a drone flight. Drones typically wobble and inch slowly toward a landing until power is finally cut, and they drop the remaining distance to the ground. At Caltech's Center for Autonomous Systems and Technologies, CAST, artificial intelligence experts have teamed up with control experts to develop a system that uses a deep neural network to help autonomous drones learn how to land more safely and quickly, while gobbling up less power. The system they have created, dubbed the Neural Lander, is a learning-based controller that tracks the position and speed of the drone, and modifies its landing trajectory and rotor speed accordingly to achieve the smoothest possible landing. This project has the potential to help drones fly more smoothly and safely, especially in the presence of unpredictable wind gusts, and eat up less battery power as drones can land more quickly, says Soon-Joo Chung, Bren Professor of Aerospace in the Division of Engineering and Applied Science, EAS, and Research Scientist at JPL, which Caltech manages for NASA. The project is a collaboration between Chung and Caltech Artificial Intelligence AI experts Anima Anandkumar, Bren Professor of Computing and Mathematical Sciences, and Yisong Yu, Assistant Professor of Computing and Mathematical Sciences. A paper describing the Neural Lander will be presented at the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers IEEE International Conference on Robotics and Automation on May 22. Co-lead authors of the paper are Caltech graduate students Guanya Shi, whose PhD research is jointly supervised by Chung and Yu, as well as Shi-Chen Shi and Michael O'Connell, who are the PhD students in Chung's Aerospace Robotics and Control Group. Deep neural networks, DNNs, are AI systems that are inspired by biological systems like the brain. The deep part of the name refers to the fact that data inputs are churned through multiple layers, each of which processes incoming information in a different way to tease out increasingly complex details. DNNs are capable of automatic learning, which makes them ideally suited for repetitive tasks. To make sure that the drone flies smoothly under the guidance of the DNN, the team employed a technique known as spectral normalization, which smooths out the neural net's outputs so that it doesn't make wildly varying predictions as inputs, conditions shift. Improvements in landing were measured by examining deviation from an idealized trajectory in 3D space. Three types of tests were conducted: a straight vertical landing, a descending arc landing, and flight in which the drone skims across a broken surface, such as over the edge of a table, where the effect of turbulence from the ground would vary sharply. The new system decreases vertical error by 100%, allowing for controlled landings, and reduces lateral drift by up to 90%. In their experiments, the new system achieves actual landing rather than getting stuck about 10 to 15 centimeters above the ground, as unmodified conventional flight controllers often do. Further, during the skimming test, the Neural Lander produced a much smoother transition as the drone transitioned from skimming across the table to flying in the free space beyond the edge. With less error, the Neural Lander is capable of a speedier, smoother landing and of gliding smoothly over the ground surface, Yu says. The new system was tested at CAST's three-story tall aerodrome, which can simulate a nearly limitless variety of outdoor wind conditions. Opened in 2018, CAST is a 10,000-square-foot facility where researchers from EAS, JPL, and Caltech's Division of Geological and Planetary Sciences are uniting to create the next generation of autonomous systems, while advancing the fields of drone research, autonomous exploration, and bio-inspired systems. This interdisciplinary effort brings experts from machine learning and control systems. "We have barely started to explore the rich connections between the two areas," Anandkumar says. Besides its obvious commercial applications, Chung and his colleagues have filed a patent on the new system. The new system could prove crucial to projects currently under development at CAST, including an autonomous medical transport that could land in difficult-to-reach locations, such as a gridlocked traffic. The importance of being able to land swiftly and smoothly when transporting an injured individual cannot be overstated, says Morteza Gharib, Hans W. Liepmann Professor of Aeronautics and Bioinspired Engineering, Director of CAST, and one of the lead researchers of the Air Ambulance Project. Toy transformers and real-life whales inspire biohybrid robot, drawing inspiration from biology and the toy shelf, researchers at Thayer School of Engineering at Dartmouth College and City University of Hong Kong have developed a swimming robot with a light-controlled cellular engine that can perform highly targeted drug delivery. Researchers combined cardiac tissue engineering, a 3D-printed wing structure and a light-sensitive gel to produce the soft robot with start-stop capability. The switchable device transforms its shape when exposed to skin-penetrating near-infrared light, causing it to drive and break through fluid environments like the human bloodstream. The transformable device dramatically improves the usefulness of robots designed to work inside the human body and other unconventional work environments. The research team at City University of Hong Kong produced the original robot design and performed the experimental tests. The Dartmouth team performed mechanical and numerical analysis on the device and suggested changes to design elements like size and shape. With this technology, we can create soft transformable robots with unprecedented maneuverability, said Zi Chen, an assistant professor of engineering at Thayer. Our inspiration came from transformable toys that have different configurations and functionality. The result is no toy, it may literally change people's lives. Living organisms are capable of changing shapes to perform specific actions. A hedgehog curls into a ball for defense. Birds spread their wings to fly. Carnivorous plants such as the Venus flytrap open and close. The new study is part of a long-term effort to develop robots that mimic this shape-changing behavior found in nature. To be effective, the new generation of robots need to be energy efficient and they must be able to respond to different types of stimulus, like light or heat. While examples of these types of robots already exist, researchers have struggled to create a device that fluently transforms its shape to allow it to start and stop moving on demand. Most existing systems also depend on temperature variations that are difficult to simulate in the human body because of its nearly constant temperature. The ability to control the robot's motion using light creates a much more functional device that can be operated with high precision, said Xiaomin Han, a recent PhD graduate from the Chen Research Lab at Thayer. The remote-controlled robot is driven by a tail fin that mimics the swimming action of whales. The structure was 3D printed in the shape of an airplane wing and then coated with heart muscle cells. In the same way that cardiomyocytes cause the heart to beat continuously, they also propel this biohybrid device through a constant undulating action. To control the movement of the robot, researchers applied photosensitive hydrogels to the wings. In the absence of light, the wings deploy, allowing the heart cells to propel it forward. When exposed to light, the floating plane retracts its wings, causing it to stop. The heart muscles keep churning, but they are unable to overcome the stopping power of the wings, said Chen. It's like pushing the accelerator pedal with the emergency brake on. The robot's high sensitivity to near-infrared light creates a response rate that allows an almost immediate transformation of wing shape, allowing it to be highly maneuverable. In the study, researchers used the unprecedented controllability and responsiveness of the floating plane robot as a cargo carrier to conduct targeted drug delivery against cancer cells. "We literally dropped drug bombs on cancer cells," said Chen. The realization of the transformable concept paves a pathway for potential development of next-generation intelligent biohybrid robotic systems. The biohybrid robot can be produced in a variety of sizes ranging from several millimeters to dozens of centimeters. Such scalability gives it good flexibility to take on tasks related to navigation and surveillance in difficult environments. A study describing the research first appeared in the academic journal Small in late March. In the current study, researchers control start-stop motion of the entire robot through the use of light. Future research will use light to target separate wings on the robot so that it can be steered with even more precision. This research was produced with Peng Shi and Bingzi Xu from City University of Hong Kong. Yu Wei Hu and Chia Hung Chen from National University of Singapore and Yiming Luo from Hubei University of Technology also contributed to the study.